Nimesh, Assistant Professor Nimesh Das here from LG Institutes of Engineering and Technology. In the previous session, we have got what is physics all about. And we already discussed the multiple domain of it. But in this session, we will discuss how the physics is offered to you. So what we are waiting for? Let's turn the page and get to the topic. So basically, it is offered by the GTU in first year, but we are offering in SEM 1. In that, it is obviously the name that is given is physics. Subject code is 311-0018 and it is offered to the group 2 branches. Now you will be having the query, what is group 2 branches? Now the group 2 branches consist of the branches such as computer, IT, ICT, EC and IC. And this I will clear at the end of the session. So now we will discuss in details the modules of it. Okay, so before that we will get to the how we are offering to you. Okay. So in that we are going with the first the teaching scheme. The teaching scheme consists of it is having the 3 hours of the lecture and it is having the 2 hours of the practical sessions for the same. After that we will be having the theory marks. So external exam would be of 70 and the internal would be of 30. So in all it is of 100 marks. Now as we have discussed theory, we'll be going for the practical. So practical is external it would be 30. And internal it would be 20. So that again gives you the sum of 50. So in all it would be now 150 marks. And now the credit for this subject is 4. So this was all about the subject details that you would be getting from the GTU. Now we will discuss the modules of it. So let's begin. So in that the first module that we will discuss is electronic materials and that consists of 22% of the same. So in that the first topic that we will discuss is free electron theory. In free electron theory we will discuss all about the valence electrons and how valence electron is actually differentiating the properties of the matter or how it is affecting the properties of the matter. Next topic is of the band theory of solids. In band theory of the solids we will get the 3 bands basically. Okay, so in that band first band would be the valence band as we know, second is the forbidden gap and third is also known as the conduction band. So there are the 3 band layer and on that band basis we will be getting our 3 type, that is conductors, insulator as well as the semiconductor. So very next topic after that would be density of energy of states. Now this will be giving you the how much energy levels are there for residing of the electrons or the available energy states. After that we have got the chronic penny model. Now the chronic penny model will get you the detail of where the electron can reside and where the electron cannot reside or they are restricted. Now for the same you will be having the EK diagram for it. Now in EK diagram you would be representing it. Okay. But we were already having the band theory, then where we are switching for the EK diagram. EK diagram also gives you the momentum across it. So energy versus momentum would be also there. After that, the effective mass of the electron. Now effective mass of the electron is there. In effective mass, you will get what is the mass of the electron in the presence of the external force exerted on it. So it can be external as well as the internal force and how your actual mass is getting changed. After that the last topic is of the Fermi level. Now Fermi level will give you the maximum level at which the electron can reside. So this was all about module 1. Now we will go to the module 2. Now the module 2 is semiconductors and it consists of the most heavy weight of entire course, that is of the 27%. Now in that the first topic get on with the types of the semiconductor. Now when we say the types of the semiconductor you will say sir it is P and N type semiconductor, but it is not like that. Basically it gets divided into the first part, that is elemental and compound, then it goes to the part of the direct and the indirect band gap. Then it goes with the intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductor and at the last you are getting the p-type and n-type under the extrinsic semiconductors. After that we have got the equilibrium carrier statistics. In equilibrium carrier statistics we will be getting you the carrier statistics of is in the intrinsic type as well as the p type as well as the n type semiconductor. So what is the concentration of the carriers in the particular region? After that, the next topic that goes with the carrier generation and recombination. Now what is that? In generation and recombination, you will only understand generation, that is nothing but building of the electron and hole pairs. So when we are generating it, electron and hole pairs, the process is known as generation. But while when we are getting the reverse process of it, it is the recombination of the same. So after that, you have got the carrier transport. Now how does the carrier travels? So when we go with the how does the carrier travels, we have got the basic two type, and that is drift and diffusion. After that, we have got the PN junction diode, then Zener diode, then light emitting diode, that usually known as LEDs, and our last is the photodiode. Now these are the different type of the semiconducting devices in which we will study the basic principle, then the working of it, then the application of it, as well as its characteristics with the same. So this all we will study in module number 2. So after that we will go to the module number 3. Now module number 3 is very interesting one, that is a light semiconductor interaction, and it has got the 17% of the weightage. In that, the first topic that we will study is nothing but the Einstein theory. In Einstein theory, we have got the basically process of building the interaction of the semiconductor along with the light. So how that light semiconducting material behaves with respect to the light interaction. So when we are doing that, we will be having the two basic processes, that is the process of generation and process of absorption. So in generation, we will be having the two emissions, stimulated and spontaneous, and the other process is absorption. On that basis, we will study the semiconducting laser. Now in our course, we have discussed the gallium arsenide laser. We will be getting the working of it, characteristics of it, as well as the application for the same. After that, we will discuss the Drude model. Now what is the Drude model? Drude model is actually the interaction of the free electron theory that we will discuss in the unit 1. It is just the excited part of that free electron theory. After that, the joint density of state. Now in the joint density of the states, we will get the what is the rate. Okay, so there is a basically two things. First is the number of the radiation. So will we study in joint density the number of radiation, and after that we will get the photovoltaic effect. And what is photovoltaic effect? The photovoltaic effect is the effect in which your light energy is actually created into the electrical energy, and by that principle we will get our solar cell. Now we all know that what does the solar cell do? It will convert your light energy into electrical energy. So in that we will study the basic principle, that is the photovoltaic effect. After that, the construction, working, application, as well as the losses that happens in that. Okay. So after that, the Fermi's golden rule. Now this Fermi's golden rule, we in joint density, we were having the number of the transition rate. Okay. And here we will be actually having the transition rates, how many transition rates are possible, that would be justified in the Fermi golden rule. After that, the last process is of exciton, and it is a very interesting one. In exciton, you will get the interaction of the holes and the electrons, but there is some electrostatic force indulged in that. That keeps these two things together. That we will study in exciton. So this was all about the light semiconducting interaction. After that, the unit number 4. Now unit number 4 is entirely of measurements. So basically when we take the two probe method, okay. So in two probe method, when we are measuring the resistivity as well as the conductivity, what is happening in that, we are having its internal resistance. So the whatever the thing we are measuring, it is not accurate one. So what we are doing, we are now taking the four probe method. Now with the help of four probe method, you are getting the better amount of the resistivity and the conductivity with less resistance in that. Okay. Now which less resistance is there? It's the resistance itself of the probes. Okay. After that, the next method is of the Van der Poel method. In Van der Poel method, it is a multiple thing. In that, we will get the resistivity, we will get the conductivity. That is the basic. But along with that, we will get the carrier concentration, mobility of the electrons or the carriers also. So Van der Poel method will justify all this thing add on. After that, if we just want to know the types of the semiconductor, okay. So in Van der Poel, we will also able to get whether the it is which type of doping is there, okay. But if we just want to know the doping, race we are not interested or we don't want anything regarding that thing, okay. So when we are going for it, we will take the hot probe method. Now it is very simple. It will just tell you whether it is a P type or N type, or you can say which type of doping is it. So that would be in hot probe method, and it is very a simple one. After that, the capacitance voltage method. Now what is happening? Your junction is working as a capacitance. Okay. So as we vary the voltage, we know that this junction will vary. So as the junction will vary, the capacitance will also change. So this theory we will study in the capacitance voltage method. Now the parameter restriction, in that it is with respect to diode only, and there also we will varying the current and we will get the voltage change. Okay. So this characteristics we will study as well as derive in the parameter restriction of diode. After that, we have got the DLTS. Now DLTS stands for deep level transient spectroscopy. What is DLTS? In that we will able to detect the traps, or in the simple manner we can say the defaults in the PN junction and the Schottky diodes. And the last one is UV spectroscopy. In UV spectroscopy, with the help of the light, okay, now what is light all about? With the help of the absorption, we will get the energy band gap. So the more the light is absorbed, the more the energy gap would be there. So this is how we can also find the energy gap with the help of the light. Now this was all about the measurement. Now the last chapter is unit 5, that is nothing but your superconductivity. Now superconductivity is standing for 17%. In that, the first topic is obviously what is superconductor. Now in that we will define superconductor on the basis of one temperature, that would be your critical temperature. So that would be only deciding whether the material is normal or a superconductor. Now on that basis, we'll go ahead with the 8 properties of the superconductor. We will study one by one each of the property of it, which is very important, which will define that why a superconductor is a superconductor itself. After that, you have got the types of the superconductor. So on the basis of the critical field, that is the magnetic as well as the temperature, we will get the two type of the superconductor, type 1 and type 2. After that, we'll have the BCS theory. Now this BCS theory will define you why any conductor becomes a superconductor. So that is the base theory of the superconductivity. After that, now we all know that the superconductor works as a diamagnetic material, but it is not an ideal one. It is not an ideal one because still some magnetic field would be penetrating in it. So when it is penetrating in it, at which depth it is penetrating, that we will study in the London penetration depth. And the last is the applications of it. In application, we will go with the maglev, that is the magnetic levitation, Josephson effect, and last would be Crichton. So this will be all about the superconductivity and the modules we have offered. Now the question was, why sir in group 2 this type of the course regarding semiconductor is provided to you? So we can say that in the journey of your engineering, what will happen, we will start studying physics. Okay, so when we are studying physics, we will get the basic of the superconductors, other semiconductors and other also. So with regard to that, we will get the basic electronics for the same. In basic electronics, we will study the basic electronic materials. And with the help of that basic electronic material, we will go with the digital logic gates. And by with the help of the digital logic gates, we will get the microprocessor and controller. So as you know the physics more, the more the other subjects become easy for you guys. So hope you guys have understood this session very well. In the next session, we will start with the module content of the chapters, and one by one topic would be there. So see you in the next lecture.